Hello dear students, welcome in this maths class. In this class we will do this question. This is from class 10 chapter 1 real numbers exercise 1.1. Question 3 is an army contingent of 616 members is to march behind an army band of 32 members in a parade. The two groups are to be marched in the same number of columns in which they can march. So in this question, it is said that there are 32 members of band and 616 members of army contingent. So these are to march in such a way that 32 members are to be stand in front and behind that 616 members are to be fitted or are to be march. So in such a way that both should be going in the same number of columns. So for understanding this question, let's take a simple example. Suppose I have four members of band. So I'm writing four band members, suppose, and six members of that army contingent. This is army contingent, six members. So we have to set them in such a way that four members in front, okay, and then six members behind. We have to make them set such a way that they should march in the same number of columns. If they are coming in four columns, then these must be completed in four columns only behind this. And if they are coming in two columns, then they should also be standing in the two columns. Let's see how. So suppose in first case, I'll take four band members in the four columns. So one, second, third and fourth. Now army members are to be arranged behind that. Here six members, so 1 2 3 4. Now two members are left, so these are not arranged properly because two are left. They all should have the same number of columns. Here if they are moving in four columns, then all these army members are not set in the four columns, so this arrangement is not possible. Let's take army band members are moving in two columns, 1 2 3 4, two columns. Now let's put these army contingent also in these two columns. Six are there, 1 2 3 4 5 6. It means these are completed, so same number of columns for these two columns are there. So it means two is the answer. There should be two columns for this small question which I have taken. It means we need to find out their HCF, because HCF of 4 and 6 is 2. So in this type of questions, we need to find out the HCF, highest common factor of 4 and 6 is 2. So they are here satisfying this condition. So here also we need to find out the HCF of 616 and 32. So let's start. So let's find the HCF of these two. I have written required number of columns are HCF of 616 and 32. So here bigger is 616. So I'll write 616 here as a dividend and 32 as a divisor. So let's see, this is 61, so 32 ones are 32, 32 twos are 64, it will be bigger, so it is going with 32 ones are 32. Now minus it, so 11 minus 2 is 9, and here 5 minus 3 is 2, so bring down this 6 also. So now let's check with 9, 32 nines are 9 twos are 18, 9 is 27, 28. So it is going with 9 only, 288. So minus it, so here 16, 8, here 8 minus 8 is 0, so 8 is left. Now bring this divisor as a dividend here, so it is going with 8 fours are 32. It means their HCF is 32. So 32 is the required answer, but here we have to write using Euclid division algorithm. So write using Euclid division algorithm. So here 616 is bigger, so we'll write 616 is bigger than 32. Apply here that Euclid division lemma. So that is dividend is equal to divisor into quotient is 19 plus remainder is 8. Now again remainder is not 0, so we should proceed with this. So we'll write here 8 does not equal to 0 because remainder does not equal to 0. So again apply here
Euclid division lemma, that is dividend is equal to, this is divisor into here quotient plus remainder. Now remainder is zero, we'll write since R is zero, so HCF, required HCF is 8. So required number of column is 8. So this we will do this question. Thanks for watching.